We are extremely pleased that you're here. It is good to come together for the purpose of co-creating. Do you agree?
Yes.
We are going to have a wonderful day together. Co-creation at its best. We see you have dragged your physical bodies here. We have not. And there are many more of us than there are of you. So, it has to be good. You know what you want? Here and now? Are you appreciating the expansion of your own desire? Do you believe that your beliefs are keeping up with your desires? Well, a desire that you are believing feels good, and one that you are doubting doesn't. And so that really is the work, for you to find some way of believing what you want. We've enjoyed this interaction immensely. There isn't anything else that we will be saying today that means more than that or really is much different from that, because that really is the work. You are vibrational beings, and you are continually emitting a vibration. And the vibration that you emit is a mix of what you desire and what you believe around it. It really is that simple. And so, as you offer a desire, your desire is empowered, really. It is focused upon by your inner being, by those like us. And so your desire is a very strong part of the equation. But sometimes, over time, your beliefs become equally strong. When your beliefs about what you want are in alignment with what you want, then you really feel wonderful, and you are on your path, on your way. You are having the experience of satisfaction and living happily ever after. But when your life causes you to focus desires into place, but aspects of your life also cause you to focus in opposition to those desires, then you don't feel good. And it really comes down to which part of this vibrational mix you give more of your attention to. If you could give more attention to your desire and less attention to your doubtful belief about it, then your desires would come to full fruition faster, and you would have more satisfaction along the way. Because under those conditions, even though it has not fully manifested, when you're believing that it's coming and you're enjoying the process of the unfolding, then you're having a good time anyway. But if you are not believing that it's coming, so you stand in a sort of continual tension, wishing that you could take the desire back, but you can't, because your inner being is all over it, fanning the flames of it, attracting to it. You wish you could take it back, but you can't, so you really have no alternative if you want to be happy, other than finding a way of believing what you are desiring. The thing that is a little tricky about that is that you are accustomed to your observation of life, and you are continually checking your progress about what is. So if what is currently manifested is lacking some of what you want, you tend to notice it, because you want to be realistic. We don't want you to be so realistic about what already is, because when you are locked on to the current manifested reality, then you don't allow room for expansion or for ease of expansion. You sort of hold yourself in a holding pattern of uneasiness. The thing that is most important for you to hear in the coming into conscious, deliberate balancing, talking about you balancing, the vibration of you moment by moment. The thing that is most important is to realize that every subject is two subjects, potentially, wanted and absent of it. So sometimes you think that you're talking about something that you want when your vibrational mix is more pointed at its absence. You don't mean for it to be that way. You've just practiced looking at reality for so long and taking score, weighing the pros and the cons and the pluses and the minuses, and being realistic for those around you because they don't want you to be unnecessarily hopeful. They don't want you to have false hope. They mean well, they just aren't helping. Because it takes a while for you to go from something that does not exist to something that does exist. In other words, we're talking about you being the creator of your own experience. And we're talking about you being a vibrational being who is vibrationally molding things into beingness. We are talking about you, through your focus, turning thoughts to things. But most humans aren't patient in the process of thoughts turning to things. Most of you just want to look around at the things that have already come about, and then you just want to talk about those things, those experiences, those realities, those what isnesses is. And so, as we're visiting with you today, we will be demonstrating this manifested reality with a gesture sort of like this. This is what you can see and hear and smell and taste and touch. This is the what is reality as far as most of you want to say it. Most of you humans, bless you. But the isness that we are talking about is a vibrational reality that, from your perspective, usually when you first begin listening to us, is not that satisfying because it's the vibrational beginning of something. It's like if you were to put a kernel of corn in the ground, anticipating that it will mature into a full stalk that will bear many ears of corn. If you were to put that kernel of corn in the ground and act like most humans do about most of the things that you are creating, you would dig it up tomorrow and eat it. You'd stomp around on the ground and say, "Where are you? Where are you? I want you now. I need you now. I'm counting on you now, 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 now. Where are you now?" And the corn, if you could translate cornness, would say to you, "Cool your jets. Give it a minute. Allow the natural process to evolve." Now that's so literal because all of that is tangible. And you might be challenging our analogy, and that's all right because every analogy is flawed in one way or another. But we really want you to understand that there are vibrational kernels of corn that you have that are in the process of maturation. And that if you're taking score too soon, not only are you not satisfied as you're looking for the maturation before you're ready to see it, but you slow it down and can hold it off into a sort of seeming holding pattern where it never comes into your awareness. And there are some things you want that feel like that. You've been wanting them for a long, 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 long time. And where are they? Where are they? Where are you? Where is it? Why isn't it here? And the reason that it isn't here every single time under those conditions is because you are more aware of its absence than you are of its presence. So we want you to find a way, play with us today, and you will find it, of finding the presence of something before you find it with your eyes and ears and nose and fingertips and tongue. In other words, if you can find the presence of something before you translate it with your physical senses, if you can accept the realness of it, the reality of it in its vibrational form, if you can zone in on that and find the satisfaction of your awareness of its vibrational beginnings, much as you do the vibrational beginnings of the seeds in the ground or even the fetus in the womb. You see parents, they get pregnant and they're very excited, but they don't have a baby yet. They have a little glob, a glob of potential. And you have so many globs of potential in your vibrational reality. So it works like this. You came from non-physical. Oh, you did, with such intent. Here into this physical body. But only a part of The non-physical you that existed before you made the decision to come into this body came with you. In other words, consciousness came with you, yes. But a larger part of that eternal you consciousness remains non-physically focused. Sometimes you call that your soul. We think that's as good a name as any. We call it your inner being, but it's the source of who you are. And that non-physical part of you is aware of everything that you are about. In fact, that non-physical part of you was clear about the you that was coming forward and never stops being aware, never stops advocating, never stops trusting and knowing about you. So here you are in your physical body, in your physical exposure to the life around you, exploring the variety, the contrast, that's the best word for it, the wanted and unwanted, the wanted and more wanted, the wanted and less wanted, the things you really, 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 really like and the things you really, 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 really don't like and the things you want and the things you carve out of this mix of humanity and experience. So you launch these rockets of desire, and we mean that in a very literal sense, because often as you are living life, you are emanating your response to life, which means you're making choices at every level of your being, even at a cellular level, all day, every day. And you're emitting this vibrational stream of consciousness that your inner being is receiving and understanding and focusing on. So there is a vibrational reality that is forming and has been forming even before you got here into your body. But now that you are here, your preferences are taken into consideration. They are understood. They are known. And this vibrational reality expands. Now, we want so much for you to accept the reality of this vibrational reality, even though you cannot see it or hear it or smell it or taste it or touch it, that we've given it a name. We call it your vibrational reality, but we call it the vortex. The vortex because it's a swirling consciousness that is gathering up, because of law of attraction, all of the cooperative components to everything that you want. And so it's a reality really worth understanding and really worth getting to know and really worth feeling for, really worth recognizing. But we want to say to you, the only way that you usually recognize it in the beginning, because it's not seeable yet, it's not tangible yet, it has not turned to things yet, is by paying attention to the way you feel, because your inner being is so involved in it that your inner being is ecstatic about its content. And when you are standing in your reality using your physical senses to determine its existence or even the details of what's in it, you come way short, because often you're looking with your physical eyes and physical senses, and so you don't see it, and so you come away from an observation of it or an attempted observation of it feeling lack, like it isn't real. We wanted so much for you to call it and know it as a reality that we named it the vortex, wrote a couple of books about it, because we want you to do your best to try to accept its existence, even though you may not be ready to receive it fully. Now, that word receive is such an important word, because when you translate with your eyes, it's easy for you to accept the realness of something. We're asking you to use your emotions in the beginning to observe the reality of this vortex. In other words, we're asking you to try to accept it conceptually, but that's asking a lot. And really, we don't ever want to put you in the position where we say, just take our word for something and go with it, because words don't teach, and no one else can know something so much that then you know it. In other words, you've got to lean in the direction of knowing it yourself. You've got to at least acknowledge that it's possible, but we want the laws of this universe, particularly the powerful law of attraction, to demonstrate for you the reality of this deliberate creative process.